With Vanguard's launch, we're kind of familiar with the Create a Class system. Last year, we saw some deviation in Black Ops Cold War and what was on offer with that Create a Class system, but a lot of what we see this year is very similar to what we saw within Modern Warfare. However, the difference is that this year, it's a little bit more in-depth. There's a little bit more to it than what we saw with Modern Warfare. And today, I want to take some time to talk about some of the areas of focus you should definitely be looking at when creating your class, because you might not be building your weapon out as best as possible and as efficiently as you possibly can. So that said, as we go along, let me know your thoughts down below. How do you prefer to kit your weapon here within Vanguard? Of these areas of focus, is there anything in particular that stands out to you? Whatever the case, drop it down below. But if you enjoyed the video, do me a favor, drop a like on the video. Let's aim for 2,000 likes on this. You guys have been seriously crushing the support lately on the channel, so thank you guys so much for that. I truly appreciate it. And if you guys are new to the channel and would like to stay up to date with all things Vanguard, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss a single thing regarding all things best class setups, tips and tricks, camo guides and tutorials, updates and information. We got you covered with all of that. So if you're interested and you'd like to join us on that road to 500,000 subscribers, if you're part of that 70% of viewers that are not subscribed, maybe consider changing that. But that said, let's jump into how you can create your class a little bit better. So the first area of focus that I want to talk about in relation to where you should be concentrating your effort in creating your class comes down to accuracy. This is actually a brand new area of focus that we've never had in Call of Duty MP before. Accuracy is a new way to mitigate the effects of bloom, something that is brand new within Vanguard and is present and more apparent on some weapons more so than others, but it's on almost all weapons in some degree. So what bloom is whenever you take your shots, it's an area of where your shots will land, but in a random amount. So whereas beforehand in any Call of Duty in the past, if you went and you shot at a wall or something like that from a long range, if you'd let that weapon come back to center, every single shot would be placed in the exact same spot. With bloom present within Vanguard, however, that's not the case. If you shoot at a longer range, some weapons again will be more apparent than others, but not every shot will line up. And in some cases, it will actually be quite far apart in where those shots may land. So kitting your weapon class and build out for accuracy is something that can be very beneficial and is something that's unique to consider for creating a class within Vanguard, something you haven't had to do in the past. For every single weapon, there's anywhere from 7 to 10 attachments that you can end up utilizing across the categories of your muzzle, your stocks, your proficiencies, your grips, and your underbarrels. Each one of these, depending on their values and how much they offer in terms of that benefit for accuracy, will decrease that bloom spread, meaning that you'll be closer to shooting more accurately every single time that weapon comes down to center. Obviously, that doesn't account for things like when you just spam fire or hold down your trigger. That's when recoil and everything comes into effect, but you're going to notice that each individual shot is more accurate. And when you consider the TTK and other factors of multiplayer this year, that's incredibly beneficial. Now, oftentimes you'll be met with cons of sprint to fire time decreases, hip fire accuracy decreases, and ADS speed slowdown, but it just might be worth it. The next category you may be overlooking are specific values that can be adjusted, more so your damage multipliers and how they can be increased. This year with Vanguard, we have a couple of attachments across your various number of weapons that can actually increase the multipliers dealt for each shot you take. The most relevant, especially right now, is that of the proficiency of vital. That increases the size of your critical hit area on enemies, meaning that that headshot multiplier, which is oftentimes a 1.5 multiplier, meaning damage and a half dealt per shot, that can be extended down to places like center mass and that chest shot location. So that's why you'll see things like the STG kill in 2 to 3 shots with the right attachments, why you'll see the Type 100 do the same even after that fix is going to be inbound for the 30 Russian short mags and the improper stacking of vital that yields. Vital's on a handful of different weapons throughout the game, and right now it's probably one of the most powerful weapon attachments that you can end up equipping, and it has absolutely zero downside. There's also a few others to consider as well. One of the bigger difference makers for me is one that's on the SVT, that being the Kovalevskaya 800mm barrel. This is the first barrel that you unlock for the SVT, and it actually makes it much better of a weapon and pretty usable early on. Brutally honest with you, I've been kind of hating my grind to level up every single weapon because oftentimes the weapons suck until around level 50, which whenever you're going up against people only using STGs, MP40s, and the stuff that they've already got maxed out, it's a pain. And with that weapon scaling, it takes forever. You can breeze through the first 2 dozen levels or so, but once you've reached level 30, that XP gap that's then present is a major difference and it just kind of drags. But this makes the SVT a one hit to the chest and up, so if you're playing as a sniper out of sorts by comparison, it is worlds better than the base weapon, and that's without the addition of Vital included in that build. So much so to the point that, just like the bar, man, I always feel so bad when I come back to this because I'm just ranking up weapons trying to farm kills, farm XP for it, and I get put into these positions where if I go guns a-blazing like I normally do, I know it's not gonna work, but I blink and then I'm on a 19 and I'm just like, ah, crap, I just camped for a V2. I feel so dirty after that, but it is something that, like you'll see in probably the gameplay clips here, it's a one shot throughout and at decent distances. So also make sure you take a look at attachments that will increase that damage multiplier and increase the lethality of the weapon in each individual shot you can take where applicable. Another area of focus that you might not really think too much about but can make a world of a difference in creating your weapon class setup is the factors with damage. And that sounds pretty self-explanatory, but you might not realize how many weapons have the ability to change their damage output to increase that. There are plenty of weapons across Vanguard that have damage modifying magazines. The STG has the 30 Russian short mags, the Automaton has the 8mm Clauser 50 round mag, the Bar has the 50 BMG rounds in both the 20 and 30 round magazine, the AS-44 has the 7.62 30 round mag, the Volk has the 30 Russian short mags, the MP40, M1928 Thompson have the 8mm, and you kind of get where I'm going with this here. Oftentimes they all do include downsides of, in some varying degree, recoil control, ADS speed, movement speed, fire rate, and similar, but it is something that, again, a lot of those do make up for that damage and killing potential if you can kit it out properly with additional things to combat those downsides. So if you're looking for something, a lot of the times the magazines themselves within Vanguard, I personally don't think have a ton of ammo potential. Like, the one that's currently crushing me is the fact that the Itra Burst is a 4-round burst weapon with only 20 rounds in a magazine, and the only magazine upgrade that doesn't decrease the damage potential is that of the 8mm Clauser 32 rounds, which you don't get until level 53, which takes a couple of hours of grinding to get to. So that's one of those things that, when you don't have a ton of magazines that I think are truly worthwhile that don't sacrifice in some way, definitely consider taking those magazines that offer more in the damage properties. Now, the next thing, in addition to what you can see in terms of ammunition, is pick the right ammo type for your playstyle and the objective and what you want to get out of each individual match. That's something that I see a lot of people just kind of arbitrarily throwing on an ammo type because it doesn't really cost you too much. But truth be told, it really comes down to what you want to get out of every single weapon. If you want to play stealthy and you want to rush around, subsonic is a great option here because you don't need a silencer, but it keeps you off the minimap, while also only sacrificing a little bit in that bullet velocity. If you're up close and personal, that's not going to make too much a difference. Frangible with no cons allows you to deal enemy healing delays and also additional movement penalties, so that's something if you're a hunter, it's again another awesome opportunity. Incendiary damage, as much as I hate it, it's actually really beneficial because if somebody finishes off a kill that you end up damaging with, if they're still damaged from that fire rounds, which they often are a little bit longer, that's going to give you even more XP towards that weapon and towards your overall rank. Lengthened, of course, bullet velocity, if you're playing at a distance, you cannot go wrong here at that one. So make sure you're picking the right ammo type that really encompasses what you want to get out of your playstyle and what you want to do. If you're a grinder going for weapon ranks, I'd say use incendiary. Try and get as much killing potential or at least assist potential out of it as possible. If you're farming long range kills, use lengthened. It really all is situational in what it comes down to. Next, the thing that a lot of players may be overlooking is how much recoil control can go into a weapon build. Across your muzzles, your barrels, your stocks, your proficiencies, grips, as well as under barrels, you have an ample amount of opportunity to mitigate some recoil here and there. Oftentimes, players will gravitate towards those under barrels. Things like your carver foregrip are awesome, your hand stops are pretty good, your bipods for mounting and crouching while prone are also pretty solid as well. But then you also get things like, on most weapons, your G28 compensator. That offers additional recoil control with absolutely no penalties whatsoever. Pay attention to your barrels as well, because just like Modern Warfare, this now brings back the sort of weighted barrel, where if your barrel is a little bit heavier, obviously your weapon isn't going to kick up as much, giving you natural recoil control that you might not need to sacrifice too much in other areas. So make sure you're paying attention to that and kitting it out for weapons that may need more control versus may not need as much control. And finally, one of the biggest things in terms of what I think people may be overlooking when creating their class is sprint to fire time within Vanguard. There are a lot of weapons that have very slow sprint to fire time and oftentimes can have that open bolt delay as well, which will get you killed more often than not if you're not not paying attention to it. If you're caught in a tax sprint, again, that factor returning as well, whereas there was not tax sprint, everybody had the same sprint out time for the most part within Black Ops Cold War. This year it can vary depending on the level of sprint you're taking part in. So sprint to fire time is absolutely something you need to pay attention to. You can get mitigation with that with things like the skeletal stock on weapons. Your various number of grips across your rear grips can work as well. And same thing goes a little bit in terms of the underbarrels you can choose, oftentimes coming down to the pistol grip for a lot of weapons, offering the most benefit in that sprint to fire time. So absolutely consider this, but truth be told, the hardest part about all of this and trying to not neglect certain areas of your create a class build is trying to find that balance, what works for you. And that is where there is no right or wrong answer. If you're somebody that absolutely loves to play a run and gun, really wants the quickest action possible, kit yourself out for that sprint to fire time ADS speed. If you're somebody that wants to farm long shots, try and get as much damage and recoil control as possible. The truth of the matter is that whenever we take a look at these six areas of focus that you really want to stress on in your create a class builds, you're not going to ever max out every single one, just because they'll have crossovers and trade-offs from other areas of focus that you'll want to take a look at. So you're never going to have a weapon that is 100% fully maxed for its sprint to fire time, recoil control, damage and output potential, as well as its accuracy, but it comes down to what you're trying to get out of it. So hopefully this helped you out in giving you at least the starting point, the basic building blocks to be able to construct your classes a little bit better, and therefore have a little bit more potential to do well in matches with weapons that may be giving you a little bit of trouble. So that said, that's where we're going to wrap it up, but before we go, a quick little editor's note here. This video was done for a couple of days now at this point, but as of this morning, this afternoon, this evening, wherever you may be in the world, you may have seen some of the reporting and the updates to the stories following what we had heard about the last couple of months taking place at the higher echelons and executive level of Activision Blizzard. That updated reporting shed some more light on the situation, and I gotta say, man, I love Call of Duty, I love the community, and I love the people who pour their heart and soul into creating the games for us to play as fans. But it's absurd, it's saddening, disappointing, and downright frustrating that the actions that are covered up, that these reports bring light to, continue to happen, that harassment, exploitation, and all continue to happen behind the scenes at a level where those in power say they've placed a zero tolerance policy in the company, but they themselves will not follow those same guidelines set by said zero tolerance policies. I, for one, and I sure hope that you guys stand by and fully support the hardworking creatives and their fight for a safe and inclusive work environment so that those zero tolerance policies aren't just simple statements made in PR stunts, but instead are standards from top to bottom. Bobby Kotick and the board of executives at Activision need to be held accountable. So I urge you, support those who need that support, the developers just trying to make games that they love and the community can love, and continue to call for change to be made here, because it's clear some change at the very top needs to happen. But anyways, that's where we're gonna wrap it up. I would love to get your thoughts and feedback down there in the comment section down below. Hopefully these tips, again, can help you out in some way, shape, or form. So if they do, do me a favor, drop a like on the video. And of course, if you are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all things Vanguard. We got a lot of stuff here still coming up, so make sure you don't miss it. There's still a lot of things from launch and then also leading into Warzone's integration here coming up very soon. Stick around on the channel if you're at all interested in any of that. But said, thanks so much for watching. My name is Espresso. I'll see you guys later. Take care and peace.